Hello guys and welcome back to another video from my YouTube channel, that is Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorial. And in this particular video we are going to talk about the roles of magnesium and sulfur. So we have already talked about many minerals as well as many elements, ki how they are absorbed, in what particular form they are abundant in soil, by which they are directly absorbed, and unki kya kya roles hote hain in the body of a plant. So now the two elements of consideration are magnesium and sulfur. So we know very well about magnesium and what is the form in which this is abundant. We know that very well. हमें याद करने की जरूरत ही नहीं है. Mg कैसे पाया जाता है? Mg dipositive form में. There is nothing new in it. This is the most common form of Mg, that is Mg2 positive, and it is also known as magnesium ion. Okay. So what are the different roles? The roles are very easy as well as you know them very well. क्योंकि हम जो पढ़ चुके हैं, we have already taken into consideration replication, transcription and different kind of things as well. तो वहाँ पर we have studied the role of magnesium. Okay, so we just have to revise that. There is nothing new in case of magnesium and sulfur. So in the synthesis of DNA and RNA, when you will talk about the replication and transcription machinery, तो वहाँ पर आपको magnesium का role मिल जाएगा. So it is quite important in the formation of nucleic acids, that is DNA and RNA. It is abundant in CHL, that is chlorophyll. We know very well कि chlorophyll में क्या रहता है? Magnesium रहता है as a central metal ion. Okay? If this is the chlorophyll, there is a complex ring-like structure. Okay? There is a porphyrin head and a phytol tail. तो वहां पर जो है मैग्नीशियम टू पॉजिटिव आयन प्रेजेंट होता है इन द सेंटर विच इज लिंक्ड विद डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ एलिमेंट्स. ओके, सो इट इज प्रेजेंट इन क्लोरोफिल. इट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द सिंथेसिस ऑफ डीएनए एंड आरएनए एज वेल एज इट हैज मेनी अदर पर्पजेस. इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट इन रेस्पिरेशन बिकॉज वॉट इज रेस्पिरेशन, लेट्स टॉक अबाउट इट इन अ वेरी सिंपल वे. रेस्पिरेशन क्या होती है? कि जब एक पर्टिकुलर प्लांट एनर्जी को सिंथेसाइज करता है, ओके, एनर्जी बनाता है. इन रेस्पिरेशन वी नो वेरी वेल कि ग्लूकोज है, द ग्लूकोज इज ब्रोकन डाउन इन ग्लाइकोलिसिस इनटू पाइरुवेट और पाइरुविक एसिड. तो वहां पर क्या होता है? एटीपी फॉर्मेशन होती है. देयर इज फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एटीपी and in some reactions the ATP is broken down into ADP and PI. So all the reactions in which ATP is either formed or ATP is broken into ADP and PI, वहाँ पर आपको side में magnesium ion जरूर मिलेगा. That's for sure. अगर आप एक high level की book पढ़ते हैं, there is no enzyme given in NCERT, but if you will take some good refresher, then you will obviously find that there is role of magnesium in some enzymes that are working in respiratory cycles. After that, there are also some enzymes which are supplemented by magnesium, which are activated by magnesium, and they are present in photosynthesis. Okay, photosynthesis mein kaafi cycle hoti hain, C3 cycle, C4 cycle. There are different kind of compounds as well as different kind of enzymes or proteins. That is Rubisco. Rubisco aap sabne suna hoga. This is the most abundant protein ever. This is the most abundant protein in universe. Okay, so Rubisco को भी क्या करता है? Activate करता है magnesium. This is quite important. Okay, so it is responsible for photosynthesis. It is responsible for respiration. It is responsible for replication, transcription. It is responsible for the formation of chlorophyll as well as ये ribosomal assembly में भी बहुत काम आता है. Now what is ribosomal assembly? We know very well that ribosome is made up of two subunits. One is large and one is small. So large or small, jo subunits hain, they are joined in the presence of magnesium ion. That's why it is responsible for the joining of ribosome subunits. This is quite important. It is responsible for all metabolic reactions. DNA, RNA, translation, transcription or replication. Replication means DNA formation, then transcription. Ribosome assembly is obviously related to translation, because protein synthesis is done by ribosomes and it is responsible for photosynthesis, respiration and chlorophyll formation. That's why it is one of the most इम्पॉर्टेंट एलिमेंट इन प्लांट्स बॉडी, क्योंकि प्लांट में जितने भी रिएक्शंस हो रहे हैं सबके लिए कहीं ना कहीं रिस्पॉन्सिबल जरूर है। सेकेंड वन इज सल्फर। सल्फर का कौन सा आयन दिमाग में आता है? सल्फर को सोचते ही देयर इज अ मोस्ट कॉमन आयन दैट इज SO4 2 नेगेटिव, दैट इज सल्फेट आयन। सो सल्फर इज एब्जॉर्ब्ड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ सल्फेट आयन्स। दिस इज ऑल्सो क्वाइट इंपॉर्टेंट एज इट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ मैनी अमीनो एसिड्स। देर आर सल्फर कंटेनिंग अमीनो एसिड्स। कौन कौन से? When we have talked about biomolecules, then we have taken into consideration amino acids. और वहाँ पर हमने sulfur containing amino acids के अलग से example लिए थे, which are quite important from examination point of view. So there are two most important sulfur containing amino acids that are methionine and cysteine. अगर आपको amino acids के बारे में कुछ नहीं पता, then you can watch my lecture on biomolecules. वहाँ पर आपको पूरी detail मिल जाएगी. These are also a part of coenzymes. This is also important that they are an important part of many coenzymes. After that, they are part of many vitamins. Vitamins are high nutritional value compounds which are needed in our diet because we cannot synthesize vitamins. Okay, वो हमें diet में चाहिए होते हैं. And ferrodoxin. When you will talk about the phosphorylation reactions in case of photosynthesis, और जब electron acceptors के बारे में हम पढ़ेंगे, then this is a very good acceptor. Okay, then we will talk about ferrodoxin, but here you just have to remember the name, you don't have to do anything. We will talk about it in detail. This is ferrodoxin. So the sulfur is present in amino acids and coenzymes. What are the amino acids? This forms a very important question in NEET as well as in JIPMER. Okay, it is going to be rarely asked in AIIMS, but in JIPMER the probability of this question is most. Cysteine and methionine are two important amino acids which are containing sulfur. जब दो cysteine residues आपस में मिल जाते हैं, okay, there is a cysteine, there is another cysteine. When they combine and they are oxidized, they forms a bond, SS bond. Okay, and that particular resulting compound is cysteine. So don't get confused between cysteine and cysteine. Cysteine is a standard amino acid, but when two cysteine molecules combine with this particular bonding, they form cysteine. And cysteine is also amino acid. When somebody talk ki kaun kaun se amino acids mein sulfur hoga, to cysteine ko bhi aap log tick kar sakte hain. Okay? But when it comes to standard amino acid, then cysteine and methionine among the 20 most common amino acids are containing sulfur. This is important concept, and this is also asked in assertion and reason type question to confuse you between cysteine and cysteine. So hame confusion nahi honi chahiye, right? So isliye maine aapko ye yahan par batana lazmi samjha. Now there are different kind of vitamins. You know very well about vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E, vitamin K and vitamin BC that are fat soluble and water soluble. Okay, so the vitamins in which sulfur is present is biotin, thiamine and coenzyme A. There is another confusion between thiamine and thymine. Thymine is a nitrogenous base which is present in nucleotides, that is DNA and RNA. Lekin thiamine is a vitamin, okay, and a sulfur containing vitamin. So yahan par bhai thoda sawal ke, kyunki yahan par cysteine, cysteine and thymine and thiamine, ye panga kar sakte hain aap logon ke sath. So just don't confuse between these confusing words. Okay, kafi baar ho jata hai, lekin isliye maine aapko dono questions yahi par bata diye jisse ki aap logon ko exams mein zyada problem na ho. So thiamine is a vitamin and thymine is a nitrogenous base. Cysteine is a common sulfur containing amino acid and cysteine is formed by the combination of two cysteines. ओके, सो देयर इज अ वेरी सिंपल ट्रिक. ट्रक्स के बगल में काफी बार लिखा रहता है, अगर आपने देखा हो तो, फट्टा बॉक्स. ओके, सो वी डोंट नीड टू मेमोराइज अमीनो एसिड और कोएंजाइम्स, वो हम सबको पता है. वी हैव टू मेमोराइज फेराडॉक्सिन, कोएंजाइम ए, कोएंजाइम ए दैट इज कंटेनिंग ए एज डिफरेंट सबस्क्रिप्ट. सो फट्टा दैट इज एफ फॉर फेराडॉक्सिन, ए फॉर कोएंजाइम ए, टी मींस थियामीन, and B means biotin, BO simply means biotin. So these are some important function as well as some important absorbable forms of magnesium and sulfur. I hope aapko ye video samajh mein aayi hogi aur pasand aayi hogi. And dobara se thoda batana chahunga ki in words mein bilkul bhi confused mat hona. Thiamine is different, thymine is different, cysteine is different, cysteine is different. Assertion reason mein kaafi baar confused karne ke liye pooch liya jayega. So I hope ki aapko samajh mein aayi hogi. Agar aapko pasand aayi to yaar like button पे हाथ मारिए एंड अगर आपको सच में अच्छी लगी तो अपने दोस्तों के साथ इस वीडियो को जरूर शेयर कीजिए. थैंक यू सो मच एंड स्टे ट्यून्ड फॉर द अपकमिंग वीडियोस.